Welcome students, we'll continue with the chapter sets. The next what you're going to learn under sets is the different types of sets. You got it on page number 4. Now first, what is a singleton set? A set which consists of only one element in it is called as a singleton set. Now for an example, if I tell you set of even prime number, a set of even prime number. So when I tell you set of even prime numbers, you know that even prime number is only 2. So you will write A is equal to 2. So you will not get any other element in it. So such type of set where you have got only one element in it is called as a singleton set. Now the second one you have got empty or null set. Empty or null set. So empty set, the word itself indicates what is it. That is, you should not be able to write any element in the set. Such type of set you call it as an empty or a null set. Now if I ask you to write any natural number between 2 and 3. Write any natural number between 2 and 3. So between 2 and 3 there are no natural numbers, because the natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4. So between these two, you don't find any natural number. So you cannot get any natural number between 2 and 3. So therefore, it is an empty set. So such type of set where you don't get any element under that, you call it as an empty set. Empty set, either you write it like this, that is, write the bracket without anything in it, or it can also write it as a, this is also a symbolic notation to represent the null set or the empty set. Now the third one, finite set. The word itself tells, finite set. Means you should have finite number of elements in it. Such type of set you call it as a finite set. Now if I tell you set of, write an set of even numbers till 10. Set of even numbers till 10. So when I ask you to write the set of even numbers till 10, you will write 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. You don't go beyond that, because I have told you to write set of even numbers till 10. So you will write only this much. So you have got countable number of elements in the set. Such type of set you call it as finite set. Then the fourth one, infinite set. Again the word tells, infinite. You can have uncountable number of elements in it. So if I tell you write set of even numbers. Set of even numbers. So what will be set of even numbers? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So the number goes on and on. Infinite number of even numbers you can write. So such type of set you call it as an infinite set. Then you have got one more type of set, that is equal sets. Two sets are said to be equal. Equal sets means you should have two sets to do the comparison. Well, two equal sets. So suppose if you got A is equal to 2, 4, 5 I have taken. And if I take B is equal to 5, 2, 4. So when you look at the elements in both the sets, the number of elements, 1, 2, 3. Here also 1, 2, 3. And the element also should be equal. You got 2 here also you got 2. 4, 4, 5, 5. So if you have got the same number of elements and same elements present in both the sets, then such type of sets you call it as equal sets, and you write that A is equal to B. The order can change. Order you can write it anyhow, but the same element should be there and the same number of elements should be present. Then such type of set you call it as an equal set. Practice set 1.2. The first one, decide which of the following are equal sets and which are not, justify your answer. So three sets are given and I have asked you to write, tell which all are equal sets and which are not, because and justify your answer means you have to give a reason why it is equal and why it is not equal. So for that what you have to write is, you have to write all these three sets A, B and C in the listing method so that it is easy for comparison. So first one, the given set A is equal to X such that 3x minus 1 is equal to 2. So you, what will be the value of x such that when you simplify this, you should get left hand side and the right hand side equal. So here further what they are given, so the only one value you will get. So for that what we will do is I will take this equation separately and find out what is the value of x. So 3x minus 1 is equal to 2, 3x is equal to 3, or x is equal to 1. So the element that you get under this is 1. X value is 1. So you have to write it as 1. And the second one, what they are given, set B, natural number, but x is neither prime nor composite. So which are the numbers which are neither prime number nor a composite number? So it is the set, the element 1. So 1 is neither a prime number nor a composite number. Then C is given as x, such that x belongs to natural numbers and x is less than 2. So writing this in the listing method, x is belongs to a natural number and x is less than 2. So which is a natural number which is less than 2? That is nothing but 1. Now when you compare A, B and C, you can see in all the three you have got the same elements. So therefore you have to write A is equal to B is equal to C. All the three sets are equal because same elements are present. So this is the justification you write, that is why they are equal, because you have got the same elements present in all the three. The second one, decide whether A and B are equal sets. Give reason for your answer. The same way you write down in the listing method, and then you write, that is set A write in the listing method, set B write in the listing method, and then write whether they are equal sets and give the reason. Third one, which of the following are empty sets? Y. A is equal to A such that A is a natural number smaller than 0. So write in the listing method, is there any natural number that is smaller than 0? You don't have anything, so you just have to write an empty bracket like this. So now here, is this a, what the question is, this, which of the following is empty set? So it is an empty set then they have told justify why it is an empty set, because there are no natural number less than 0. So like this you have to give the reason why it is an empty set. Now in this, the second sub question, they have given B is equal to X such that X square is equal to 0. So which number when you square it, you will get it as 0, that you have to write it. So when you square the number 0, you will get it as 0. You have got the element 0 there, because when you square the number 0, you are getting. So the element here is 0. So is this an empty set? So it is not an empty set. It is not an empty set because you have got the element 0 as the, you have got 0 as the element of the set. So you have to write the reason, because 0 is an element of the set, it is not an empty set. Question number 4. Write with reasons which of the following sets are finite or infinite. So here also you write down the elements in the listing method, then you will come to know whether they are finite set or infinite set. So the first one they have told, A is equal to x such that x is less than 10, and further they told that x is a natural number. So here what you have to do is, condition given is x is less than 10. So what all are the natural numbers that is less than 10? So you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So less than 10 means only you have to write it till 9. So you have got finite number of elements. You can count the number of elements in this set. So you have to write it is a finite set. Second one, b is equal to y such that y is less than minus 1 and y is an integer, they have told. So here they have only given b is equal to y, where y is less than minus 1 and it is an integer, no limit is given. So y is less than minus 1 means you get minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, so that goes on and on. So this will be infinite set. So like this you have to write the elements. If you are able to count, you have to write it as a finite set. If it is not, if you cannot count the elements, uncountable elements are there, then you have to write it as an infinite set.